drama team, just to kind of set up some of the things that kind of can happen in our relational world. And so would you give them a welcome as they present the Hoperah show?
Welcome tonight to this live recording of the Hoperah show. You must be so excited. This is a fantastic night. We would just like to warm up your hands. That's it. So when I hold up this card, that's good. That's fantastic. Okay, so we're going to let you know because we're going to have Hoperah here in 8, 7, count with me, 6, 5, 4. Each year we get hundreds and hundreds of letters, tapes, videos from right across the nation asking for a makeover. Well, you would be surprised at how many people need help with their hair, makeup, clothing and relationships. Well, the team and I have selected 3 viewers and invited them and their spouses onto the show today for an extreme relationship makeover. Woo! But before we meet these guys, we're going to look at some footage that they have sent in pleading and asking for help from Hoperah. So we're going to listen now to Sharon as she explains about her football maniac husband.
Dear Hoperah, I'm married to a total Collingwood footy maniac. Gary lives in a complete time warp from the 80s, from his hair to his clothes. It doesn't bother me as much as the fact that the only place we go out to is the MCG or the Telstra Dome. I love him and he's good to me, but how do I get it through to him that there's more to life than football?
Please welcome Sharon and Gary Hogan! Good, thanks, Gary.
You can call me Gazza.
Gazza.
Yeah, nice place you got here, love. Hey. What are all those yobbos gawking at?
This is a live television program, Gary, and that's our studio audience.
Ah, bit like footy, eh? Bunch of galas! Yeah, Shaz said we were going to go on some show, the Hoperah show. Yeah, never heard of it. But keep plugging at it, love. One day he might be as big as Eddie.
Eddie.
Yeah, you know, Eddie Maguire. Huh? The biggest name in the history of television. Yeah?
Never heard of him.
Nah, don't worry about it, love. You'll kick a goal sooner or later.
Thank you, Gary. Why don't you have a seat? Okay, we are now going to look at our next viewer, Dave, who's going to explain to us how frustrated he gets with his wife.
Dear Hoperah, I need help. My wife and I have 3 children. My wife, Karen, she's a great mum, but that's the trouble. That's all there is in her life. It's like she's forgotten about us. About herself, our relationship. We never do anything anymore. As a couple, she's too frightened to get a babysitter. I want my wife back. What do I do?
Please welcome Dave and Karen McKenna.
McKenna!
How are you going? Now, our last viewer, Virginia, has sent in a plea for help from her distracted husband.
Dear Hoperah, hi, I'm Virginia, and I am at my wit's end. My husband and I have a beautiful baby girl, and I'm terrified that he just doesn't even know she's here. He's always so distracted with work, his laptop, his mobile, the latest CD or DVD. I really need him to be a dad. How do I get his attention? I've tried everything.
Please welcome Virginia and Heath Richmond. Well, welcome to the show. We've all, I'm sure, our technical crew have shown you the footage out the back there. But what I'm really concerned about is how do you feel that your spouses have gone to so much trouble to get your attention? Gary, is it true that we're going to need to call in the fashion police?
Oh, truth, love. I mean, what's wrong with the old hair and clothes? And Shazza, you never complained before, and I thought you loved the footy. I mean, that's where I proposed to you, love. Yeah, just as Peter Dacos was kicking the winning goal against Carlton. Dacos picks up the ball, nowhere to go, kicks it over his head. Umpire says, winner. That's what you are to me, love. Winner.
Okay. Karen, how do you feel about the suggestion of Dave's that you are totally preoccupied with the children?
Well, I realise I spend a lot of time with the children. It's just that I feel so incredibly responsible. I'm quite fearful about leaving them with anyone else. I can't help it. But I didn't realise it bothered Dave so much.
Okay, now Heath. Heath! Is it true that you're so distracted you don't even know you're a dad?
Oh, not sure about being distracted. Of course I know I'm a dad. I love my daughter. As for gadgets, everybody's got a mobile phone.
Well, yeah, everyone has a mobile phone, but did I see you walk in with a laptop computer onto the set?
Just habit, I guess.
Just habit, but I think the studio audience and I might want to know exactly how many gadgets you are carrying on you. I think you should show us. So what, we've got a laptop computer, a mobile phone, an iPod, a Palm Pilot, mobile phone number two, three mobile phones, three.
This one's for personal calls and the other one's for updates.
Updates. I'm not even going to go there. I think the studio audience and I would agree that you guys need a lot of help. And so we are going to bring Lindsay, our stylist, onto the show right now, and we are going to send out Gary, Karen and Heath backstage for a makeover. Woo! Now, while they're gone, we are going to show you some amazing footage. I gave Gary, Karen and Heath the chance to prove their spouses wrong by asking them to organise a special romantic date with their spouses. The results are unbelievable. So let's have a look at the first date with Gaza football maniac. And I think you can imagine what is going to happen. Now, Sharon, can you explain to us what's going on?
Well, I'm getting ready for a night out. So I was very excited about going out with Gary. And then, you know, he decided to accessorize.
And then he took you to a restaurant?
Yep, he didn't. He took me home. He actually just took me to the dining room. And I was really disappointed because I wanted to go out for once.
Oh my gosh. Now, please tell me he's bringing out a whole cooked meal for you that he's gotten from a restaurant.
Well, he did say he was going to cook a gourmet meal for me. So,
what is that?
It's a 4-20 meat pie.
I'm actually speechless at this point. I mean, at least he's got the little doily thing happening on the tray there.
But I don't eat meat pies.
Well, what is that?
It's a Collingwood Coke cooler.
A Coke cooler?
Yep, and Gary said that pine sauce gets you in the mood.
In the mood? Are you going to watch like the Titanic or Gone with the Wind now or something?
No, we'll be watching the football video that Gary's watched 100 times before, Collingwood versus Essendon, grand final, 1990.
I can see you're not too impressed.
No.
He looks quite happy though.
I was so bored. It was terrible.
I can't believe this. You are totally not into this at all, sweetheart, are you?
No.
And he's stealing your pie.
Yeah.
Okay, we're now going to have a look at the next date with Dave and Karen, and hopefully this will be special and romantic. Okay, Dave, tell us what's happening. You're going to a beautiful restaurant.
Well, this is me just rolling up to our special romantic sort of location. I just arrived. I'd been looking around for a car, but I couldn't find her car. So
McDonald's?
Yeah, that's special. That's McDonald's.
Did you know you were going to McDonald's?
I didn't think so. I couldn't believe it. I thought, I'll have to go in and have a look. So
she's given you the address, but not told you the venue.
Yeah, I just got a message on my mobile saying, meet me there. But I didn't know it was McDonald's.
Uh-oh. No sitter.
She'd brought the kids along once again. She's too scared to leave the kids with the sitter.
Well, they're cute kids. But not what you would take on a special romantic date.
No, not at all.
And how are you feeling right now?
I was pretty disappointed. I was asking her why she brought the kids along. And she's just saying...
She's cute. Well, what is Sharon thinking right now? Like, does she think for her this is a special romantic date?
Well, she thought McCafe. It wasn't Macca's. It was McCafe.
So McCafe is more special than McDonald's?
Yeah, because they serve coffee and cake.
Oh, okay. Well, the kids are sure enjoying themselves. Even the baby's getting into the fries.
Well, I thought if you can't beat them, join them.
Nothing like some good McDonald's, eh?
Certainly is. Well, I didn't get my romantic dinner, so I thought I'd just tuck into a burger.
Okay. I think you're getting the picture. We're going to look now at the date with Virginia and Heath, and this one is a doozy. Okay, Virginia, you're looking happy. What are you doing?
Well, we're at the coffee club, and I thought that Heath wanted to spend some family time with me and the baby. But it soon turned out that he was spending time with his gadgets. So the entire time I was trying to talk to him and try to get his attention. Honey, honey.
He's too busy to even take the spoon out of his hot chocolate.
I said, look at the baby, and I just couldn't get his attention at all.
Is he always like this?
Well, I don't want to use that word always, but for Heath's case, yes. See, Hoper?
Girl, I think you could be standing on your head and he would not notice you at all.
Uh-huh.
That's unbelievable. Well, at least you're trying to have conversation with yourself.
Yeah, I know. And the baby.
Well, what are you doing now?
I figured that this super romantic date isn't going anywhere. I figured I might as well just pay for the bill. And I told him, I said, look, take care of the baby while I'm gone.
Look at her.
But you gotta see what happens next.
His phone's ringing. Oh, I got a bad feeling about this.
The thing with Heath
the is second that phone is ringing.
Exactly. The thing with Heath is that every call is important.
Where's he going? Where is he going?
He's walking away.
He's getting reception and he's leaving the baby.
Exactly.
Aww. Look at her.
Oh my gosh.
What was going through your mind when you came back?
I was not happy. I just wanted to get my hands around his neck, basically.
I don't think any of that needs explaining, except to say we need to bring these guys back on. They've got a lot of explaining to do. And let's have a look at what Lindsay has done with these amazing makeovers. Okay, let's go. Amazing, don't they? Let them know. Give them a big round of applause, Lindsay.
Come and explain to us what you've done with Gary here.
We got rid of the mullet, slicked back the hair. We kept with the Collingwood colours, black and white. Pinstripe pants, white shirt, black jacket.
Are you loving that, Sharon?
Beautiful.
Excellent. Karen, you look amazing. How do you feel? You feeling great? Look, what's happened here?
Well, she's a busy mum, so no fast, simple look. This outfit here, she can go out on a date with her husband, but still work with the kids.
Fantastic. I'm loving it. I'm loving it. What's happening over here? Look, I like the look that you've got the whole dad thing going. Take the jacket off. Let's have a look. You've got a nice knit under... No pockets.
Yeah,
no pockets?
No pockets.
No gadgets. Okay, give them another round of applause while they take their seats. Thank you, Lindsay. Thank you very much. We'd like to thank Man to Man at Eastland for dressing Heath and Wombat at Eastland Shopping Centre for dressing Karen. Now, guys, you all have a lot of explaining to do, which I think you're going to need to do at home because our show is running out of time. Okay, but I just want to know, Gaz, actually, I'm going to give you some advice. Okay. Next time you have a nice, special, romantic date, ask Sharon what she would like to do. Do you think you could do that?
Yeah, it's a good idea. Yeah. Next time, Shaz, it's your turn. Whatever you want to do, okay? Although I do draw the line at wearing those fancy Pierre cardigan shirts with flowers on. Okay?
Now, Karen, my advice to you is get a babysitter. Your husband wants to spend some time with you. Do you think you can do that?
Oh, yes. I feel fantastic. I can't wait to show my new look with my hubby.
Excellent. And Heath, you left the baby.
I was really shocked when I saw the tape and... I'd never do anything to jeopardise my daughter, so from now on, all the gadgets stay at home, we're out.
Excellent. Well, you guys have been fantastic. Thank you so much for coming on to the show. I'd like you all to join with me tomorrow on the Hoperah Show, where we talk about women and hairy underarms, to shave or not to shave. We'd love to see you then. Bye for now.
Give him a great big thank you. That was awesome. And off applause to home for a few people.